matter how good is, he has been better than good. And we know this is Palm Sunday. And in the 33 years that he did good, healing, performing miracles, opening the eyes of the blind, causing the lame to walk, opening up the ears of the deaf. Yes, they cried, Hosanna, save us. Hosanna, save us. This morning, we cry, Hosanna. We've come to give you all the glory and the honor. You are the Prince of Peace. You're the King of Kings. You're the Mighty One. You are the Everlasting Father. There is none like you. Just begin to wave your hand and just say, Hosanna, save us today. Hosanna, do it for me today. Hosanna, deliver today. Come on. Hosanna, heal today. Hosanna, make a way out of no way today. We cry, Hosanna, Hosanna. to the one that endureth until the end. Problems, oh yes,
Verse 1, and when they came nigh to Jerusalem unto Bethphage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sendeth forth two of his disciples. Verse 2, and saith unto them, go your way into the village over against you, and as soon as ye be entered into it, ye shall find a colt tied, whereon never man sat. Loose him and bring him. And if any man say unto you, why do ye this? Say ye that the Lord hath need of him, and straightway he will send him hither. Verse 4, and they went their way and found the colt tied by the door without in a place where two ways met, and they loosed him. Verse 5, and certain of them that stood there said unto them, what do ye loosing the colt? Why are you loosing the colt? Verse 6, and they said unto them, even as Jesus hath commanded, and they let him go. Jesus said, loosen. Verse 7, and they brought the colt to Jesus and cast their garments on him, and he sat upon him. And he sat upon him. I want to talk about, Lord, sit on me. Yes, Lord. sit on me. Sit on me. This passage is usually reserved for Palm Sunday, but it is a very important message that is practical and applicable to us. It is the narrative of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. And he fulfills the prophecy. And it is the event that shifts the tide and aroused the hatred and loathing of the Jewish rulers. For in one day, they go from being silent and contentious to being violent and envious. It starts off with instructions and a mission. And while the instruction is to the disciples, the mission is for the colt. He told the disciples to go and get the colt. The disciples could not carry out the work that Jesus needed in this instance to be performed, but it was to be performed by the colt, an untamed colt. My grandmother taught, I told you once before, at Turner High School, in referring to students who misbehave in school, she would say that you are uncouth, unrefined, and untamed. Like the donkey, we, before we met Christ, was uncouth, unrefined, and untamed. I was a whole lot of uns, uncivilized, unreliable. You couldn't depend on me. Uncaring, unconcerned, untrained, unstable. But one day he sat on me, changed my whole outlook, changed my walk, and changed my talk, changed my mindset, changed my personality. I was untamed. Don't sit there looking at me like you've been saved and sanctified and baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. God had to sit on us to tame us, to untie us, to loose us. Let's talk about this event, and I won't be long. After he rode in on this donkey that had been untied, untamed, and then he sat on him. The first place he went, you got to hear this, on that donkey, according to Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Matthew, the 21st chapter, in the 12th verse says, after he rode in, the first place that he went to was the temple, the church. Mark 11:11 says that after he rode into Jerusalem, he went to the temple, the church. Mark says he went to the church. Luke says he, first of all, he wept and looked over the city. And he cried. That was the second time he cried. He cried at the grave of Lazarus. Remember, the Bible says Jesus wept. But then when he rode into Jerusalem and looked over this city of ruin and sin, the Bible says he cried. You got to hear this. When he went into the city, when he went there and walked into the temple, guess what he did? He drove folks out. This is Jesus. Now you got to understand, he was both human and divine. They were selling in the church. They were gambling in the church. Can you imagine Jesus running folks out of the church? Well, Jesus is some folks that still need. To run out. Help me, Holy Spirit. Somebody's not buying that. It's all right. Jesus still need to run some folks. He need to change some ways, some things that we brought in, we need to shoot back out. The things that we took out, we need to bring back in the church. He got a whip, a scourge. Jesus got angry, overthrew the tables. Because read it, they were selling, trading and buying and gambling in the church. Brothers and sisters, I'm sorry. It's some things we ought not do in the presence of the Lord. It's some things we have taken for granted in this modern society. It's some things we are saying it's all right. Let it go. That's why we cannot get respect from our children, because we are not given respect. We were taught coming up. Maybe I'm talking to somebody who knows what I'm talking about. We were taught how to respect God, how to revere God, how to love God, give him first place in our life. We were taught how to give reverence to God, to give him the honor, the glory. We were taught how to respect him. We just didn't come in any kind of way. Some people wanted to try to get it together, but they found out you can't just get it together. Just come to Jesus. That's why I serve him. You could come to him just as you are. You don't have to buy no new suit to come to Jesus. You don't need no new clothes. You don't need nothing else, but just come as you are. Give him your life. Give him your heart. He'll make your life brand new. How many know what I'm talking about? Because when you are untamed, uncouth, out of control, look at somebody and tell them, I was out of control too. Didn't have heaven in your view, but thanks be unto God. And somebody ought to be jumping almost over the seat and said, thank you, Jesus. Reverend is talking about me this morning. He don't even know he's talking about me. But thank you, Jesus. He's talking about me because that's the way I used to be. But thanks be unto God, I'm not what I used to be. I don't go where I used to go. I don't even like the things that I used to like. And some folks I don't care for. Preach, Greg said he will. Listen. Ran people. He ran them out of the church. I said, is that what he did? Now, read it. Took a scourge, a whip, and start running folks. So this. Some church and so many words. You've turned it into a den of thieves. But it's my house of prayer. People can go and I will make my presence known. How many came here today for God to make his presence known? You didn't come for nothing else. You came to see Jesus, as we said last Sunday. How many really came to just worship him, just to magnify him, just to lift him up? You didn't care who saw you do whatever you did. As you got in here, you start blessing the Lord. You knew what you had been through all week long, hell and high water, but you came to Jackson Memorial saying, in the rain, I'm going to bless God. I don't care if it be a tornado, I'm going to praise God. I don't care if it's a tornado watch, I'm going to go through and praise God and give him an anyhow praise, because I need an anyhow blessing. Somebody can't understand that if you praise him anyhow, he'll give you an anyhow blessing. How many need an anyhow blessing? A right now blessing. A me too blessing. A come on the scene blessing. I dare you to touch two people and say, I need a blessing from the Lord. Now, let me get to the message, because you got to hear this. He rode into Jerusalem. People were talking about him. I told you this. They was talking about him, the word had gotten out. He had just raised Lazarus, right? Right before he rode into Jerusalem, he had just raised Lazarus from the dead. That was talk about Lazarus. But look at John, the 12th chapter, the 9th and the 10th verse. You got to hear this. Everybody was excited about Jesus, but the preachers. I'm breaking it down because that's the way it's given. The ministers, the preachers, the bishops, the apostles. They began to plot. Now he had messed up the church, because somebody was getting some money somewhere under the table. Y'all better talk to me now. I read this thing here. They had messed up. They messed up the church. They messed up the church. Jesus had messed up the church. Ran people out, big time folks. He ran the sinners out, big folks who made big contributions to the church. He ran them out. And then look at the chief priests. The chief priests, they began to plot. And they wanted to kill Jesus. And look at that 10th verse. And it says, and Lazarus, what? Say it again. And Jesus and Lazarus also. They wanted to kill Jesus and Lazarus. But now wait a minute. Jesus had just raised Lazarus. He had already been dead one time. And here they are wanting to kill him again. The man had already been in the tomb. Jesus had raised him up. Lazarus come forth, and here the chief priest talking about killing him again. You know, it's folks that, help me, Holy Spirit. You have to be careful about the spirits that you're around and the people that you're around. There's some folks who wish you were dead. And even in your heart, if you wish somebody was dead, the Bible says you are just as guilty as a murderer. Oh, help me, Holy Spirit. There's some folks don't like you and don't know why they don't like you. But just go on and get over it and say, it's all right. I'm just going to praise God anyhow. It doesn't matter who liked me, who cared for me. I'm just going to praise God like I'm going out of my mind. I wonder, do I have any praises in here, real praises in here, who don't mind just lifting up their hand and just praising God on this Palm Sunday. I told them it won't be long. Praise him because they rolled in saying, Hosanna, Hosanna. Praise God. But a few days later, they began to cry, crucify him. Let me tell you, some folks will smile in your face. And the same folks that smile in your face are the same ones who's trying to wait until you make a mistake. They're trying to wait until you fall. They're trying to wait until you go down. But I came to tell somebody, go on and praise him anyway. It doesn't matter how people feel about me. Praise him anyhow. It doesn't matter how my family feel. I got to praise him anyhow. It doesn't matter what opinions say. I got to praise him anyhow. I told him I'm not going to be long, did I? I need about 10 people who don't mind walking down, coming toward the altar and give God a praise like it's your last praise. Oh, he's been too good. He's been too kind. And one thing I like about him, he sat on me. That's enough to praise him for. When I was sick, he sat on me. Outdoors, he sat on me. In trouble, he sat on me. When I didn't have a dime, he sat on me. Made a way for me. Is there anybody here know that God is able? Is anybody here know that he's all right? I need some real praises to come on down and praise him like you never pray, pray, pray him before. Don't be so cute. Quit looking at everybody else just to see what they're going to do. You got some troubles. You're going through some storms. You're going through some tribulation. You're going through some trials. I wouldn't sit cool right here. I need the whole church to walk down. Then I'll let us go home. I need the whole church to walk down toward the altar. And then I'm going to give the benediction. Help the Holy Ghost. Come on out, choir. Make your way to the altar. I need some real saints on this Palm Sunday. I done broke tradition, broke protocol now. The Spirit is here. God is showing up. He's showing up. He needs to heal somebody. He's showing up. He's trying to save somebody. He's showing up. He's trying to bring a child home. He's showing up. He's trying to get a child off drugs. Showing up. Trying to get that husband in order. That wife in order. Showing up. Showing up. He showed up. He's here right now. Going to praise him like you never praise him in your life. And tell him thank you for showing up. I need you in my home. I need you on my job. Need you in the school. Show up, God. Show up, God. Help me right now. Ow! Oh, no! Go to praise him. Praise him. Shabak him right now. I said shabak him right now. Watch this. The door of the church is open. Praise him. So you won't say, I forgot to open up the doors of the church. The door of the church is open. You can come in any moment. I dare you to praise him. Praise him. I dare you to praise him. I dare you to praise him with a loud prayer. I dare you to praise him. Watch this. Look at somebody and tell them you better praise him right now. You don't have but a few minutes to praise him. Unto him who's able to keep us. Go to praise him. Praise him right now. Praise him right now. Praise him right now. looking like you're gone out your mind. And I want you to do this. Go get your offering and praise him. Get your offering, drop it in, praise him, walk out the door. Tell him thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Stop praising him. Don't stop praising him. Come on. We're going to praise him as we give. Watch this. Come on. Lead him out, usher. Come on. Give him a sacrificial offer. Give him an extra Palm Sunday offering. That's it. I feel all right. Come on, choir, hit it. I feel all right. Yeah.
I feel all right.
Come on, lead them out. My body, but not my soul. I said, get right, church, and let's go home. Oh, get right, get right, get right, church. Who's that under dressing ready to look up the children that Moses led? I stepped in the water, water was cold. Cheer my body, but not my soul. Good right, church, and let's go home. Get right, get right, get right. When the saints go marching in, when the saints go marching in, oh, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in.
For worshiping with us today. We know that you enjoyed the ministry of music and the ministry of the word. We'd like to invite you at this time to give as the Lord has blessed you. What we know that during this time of famine, God is causing you to flourish because you are God's people, and because you are God's people, God is concerned about the things that concern you. So we'd like to invite you to give today. At Jackson Memorial, there are three ways you can give. Number one, you can give by going to our website and simply putting in www.jacksonmemorialbaptistchurch. And once you're there, you'll see Givelify. You can give through Givelify. The second way you can give through electronic giving is through PayPal. So both of those are found on our website. And the third way you can give is simply by picking up the phone, dialing 404-691-4238. Again, 404-691-4238. Someone will be happy to receive your offering over the phone. During these times, we want you to know that our pastor, Reverend Dr. Gregory Anthony Sutton, is certainly praying for you. If you have a prayer request and you want someone to pray with you and to pray for you, inbox us on Facebook and someone will be praying for you. I tell you this, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. So as you give your tithe, as you give your offering, The Lord will certainly bless you. Let us pray. Father, we're grateful today for who you are, and we thank you for everything you've done in our lives up to this moment. Now, Father, here we are. We're giving our gifts to you, and we thank you, God, that as we give, you will bless your people, some 30, some 60, and some 100-fold. God, bless those that desire to give but maybe didn't have it. But God, we thank you that in their heart they had a desire to give. And because they desired to bless the church, to bless the ministry, God, we thank you that you will bless them. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, we look forward to the next time that we can be together. Until then, God bless you from Jackson Memorial Baptist Church.